Like Krishna says in the Bhagavad Gita, there are three types of karma. There is karma, there is akarma, and then there is vikarma. So vikarma is when we are doing something, activity which is against the scriptures. It gives us bad results. We suffer. And then karma is something that we do, let's say, good activities. It gives us good results and then we enjoy. But the problem with karma and vikarma is good and bad. We keep doing it. Then we have some consequence and that consequence encourages us or motivates us to execute another action, whether good or bad. And then again, after performing that action, whether it is good or bad, we do another action and then there is a consequence for that action. And again, the whole thing, what I'm trying to say, it's very cyclic. Our life is not linear. It's not that there is cause and then there is, effect and then there is a full stop. It's not like that. It goes roundabout and roundabout. So now what is happening? The cycle of karma, vikarma, karma, vikarma is keeping us in this cycle of material world, birth, death, old age and disease. The only way one can get out of it is by doing akarma. And akarma is devotional service. And the best opportunity for us to do this akarma is especially during these kind of tithis, like Purushottam month. So why? Because during the other months, one may be motivated to do something because of good tithis available, some auspicious work, some ritualistic activities. But because Purushottam month, there is no such thing available. The only activity that a person can do is akarma, that is devotional service, because only that has effect in Purushottam month. So it is very, very important, because only these kind of tithi and the activities associated with these kind of months can remove us from this cycle of birth and death. So what is this Purushottam month? When does it happen? Why does it occur? So the mathematical calculation is the Vedic system follows two calendars, the solar calendar and the lunar calendar. The solar calendar is according to the movement of the sun. So now there is a little difference between the movement of the sun and the movement of the moon, the way they complete their orbits. So the moon completes its orbit in 354 days, point something. And the sun completes its orbit in 365 days, point something. So now there is a difference of around 11 days between the sun and the moon completing its whole orbit. So now what happens every year that this 11-day difference keeps accumulating, by the end of 3 years, it becomes like a whole 1 month of difference between the solar and the lunar calendar. So now just to make this both calendars equal, there is one extra month added. So this extra month comes every 32 months. 32 months, 16 days, 8 ghadis. One ghadi is 24 minutes. So after every 32 months, 16 days and 8 ghadis, they add this adhik mass. So adhik basically in Sanskrit or Hindi means adhik, that is extra month. So usually we have 12 months, but after every 32 months, this adhik mass has been added to balance or make the solar and the lunar calendar equal.
Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna, Krishna, Krishna lage. Sab Krishna.